Hello, I'm Jamie Carson. Joining me in the Access Sarasota studio today is Wayne Applebee, the county's director of homeless services, and Dr. Robert Marbut, a nationally known expert who has worked on the homeless issues for more than three decades. Dr. Marbut was contracted by Sarasota County and the City of Sarasota to develop a strategic plan for improving efficiency and organization of homeless services within our community. Area officials will consider his proposed plan as they determine how to move forward in addressing homelessness within the county. Welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. I understand your time is very valuable right now, and you're meeting with a lot of groups out in our community and discussing, you know, your plan and the way forward. So I appreciate you taking a few moments to come in. Let's talk a little bit about your plan and some of your observations. You know, in your experience with other communities, how does Sarasota County compare?
In many ways, you're similar to other Florida cities. You mm-hmm. have the basic demographics. And again, most of people need to remember, homelessness doesn't occur in Michigan or North Dakota, South Dakota. People don't say, gosh, I'm looking forward to being homeless. I'm going to go up to Montana in the middle of the wintertime. That's yeah. not what happens. Most of the homeless is within 50 miles of the water, with the exception of a few places like Las Vegas and the San Joaquin Valley of California. Most of the homeless is near the beach line. It's where tourism is. And there's always going to be this yin and yang in tourist communities and visitor communities and retirement communities, homeless, because they both groups are seeking the same thing, a nice moderate weather. So that is all the normal. That's the norm. That's mm-hmm. all the basic. The demographics are about the same. One third are veterans, in particular the U.S. Marine Corps and Bravo 11s or infantry in mm-hmm. the Army. And so again, that is pretty common. What made Sarasota a little different is you have a real crisis going on with your families and children, especially down in South County, mm-hmm. in relative terms to the nation. So your families with children is off the charts. You have five children per school day going homeless, brand new every day, five new children. So in every given week, you have 25 new children becoming homeless during a school day. So that is very unusual for the size of the community. A couple other things is you have a lot of street community that are living out in the woods, who live in the woods, who come in from the woods, and so the encampments have to be addressed. That's probably higher than other places, other than maybe exceptions like up in Arkansas. I've seen some folks up in the mountains that are more that way, but that's an unusual thing. On a positive side, your homelessness is actually quite nonviolent relative to the rest of the country. Your encampments have many more women in as a percent than others. That's an indication of lower violence. You also have a lot less dogs in your encampments, and dogs are your alarm system. And so, you know, that's the good news, you know, is that some places, homeless communities have become very violent over time. That has not happened here. But you don't want to get to that point. If you get to that point, then you have a whole nother set of problems. So you're addressing it right at the critical time, in particular in terms of the adult chronic homelessness.
So as we look at your plan, and you know, you mentioned we're at the crisis levels with the family and the children, and with the female population within the homeless, you know, let's talk about some of your recommendations for the county and the community on how to address those issues.
I have a lot of systems improvement. The mm-hmm. big thing to understand is what I bring forth is not a box or a building or a singular program. It's about restructuring the whole system. Peter Drucker talks a lot about systems approach, and that this is very much a systems approach. Mm-hmm. And it's all interconnected. We talk about how to improve the software, how to improve interagency interaction and interaction. We talk about how the foundations should tweak how they give their funding and reward agencies that are engaging, and candidly stop giving money to agencies that are enabling. We talk a lot about the culture of a community. Stop giving money out the car, stop feeding out the back, feed in an organized, holistic environment. So a lot of this is cultural driven, a lot of it systems driven. We also call for five different precise facilities, a north and south portal for families with children, an intake portal. Mm-hmm. We talk about two possible villages villages. One in the North County, we have a pretty good fix on for the family village. The South County, we have some options we're looking at. And then the one that always gets a lot of the media attention is the chronic men's and women, or the adult men and women's site. And so that's, we outlined, I ended up reviewing about 65 sites for that one.
I understand in your proposal, and I'm sure you saw that there was the one ideal location, although there is no such thing as ideal, more of the near perfect, I think, was in your plan, a location, and three good ones. As you guys are going out into the community and discussing Dr. Marbut's plan, what's the feedback that you're hearing from the community about, are they energized? Is there a renewed focus in the community about addressing this issue?
I think most certainly. Everyone that I've been engaging with, and I think Dr. Marbut would say the same, is people are ready to act on this issue, and they understand that we have some tough decisions and some tough challenges to get through. But I think people have poised themselves to be ready to tackle the issues and work through it. And certainly, the adult men in chronic homeless shelter that Dr. Marbut proposes, is certainly one of the challenges to locate it. As you mentioned, there's never an ideal site, but we have to look at all of the factors and what's best for our community to raise everybody's level of quality of life in this community, no matter where you are or who you are. And to do that, we can do that with a shelter that's in the appropriate location with the appropriate systems in place to be able to make a difference in our community. So I'm hopeful that we'll continue this conversation, get all of the questions answered that people need answered, and we'll be able to get through that issue.
As you talk about talking with the community, we have different area officials. Dr. Marbut, in your experience with other communities, how our different officials are working together, seems to be in a positive manner. Is that something that you've seen before, or is Sarasota County kind of really coming together to focus on this issue?
Well, normally I don't get called into a community that's doing very well with homeless. I normally get the call once things are messed up, or they're simply not working. But what we've been able to do everywhere we go is we've been able to get a lot of different agencies, a lot of different of the elected officials, appointed officials, to start working together. People like public defenders are absolutely critical in this. The state attorney is critical in this. And if we move forward with the option that I like the most about having the sheriff be the lead, and he has said he's willing to do this if he's asked and everybody agrees to it and such. He and his office would be an ideal to operate this. And when you start talking about systems and safety and security and buffer zones, having the sheriff involved in a facility like this and be able to bring the law enforcement component with the agency component and the case management component all in one place, you get some great synergism of operations of different agencies working together.
I saw Sheriff Knight's comment about being ready if that's what the area officials decide. It's for for our viewers watching and the ones that are reading the media coverage about this issue in their community. What's their next step? What should they be looking for as far as what area officials are going to do next, with Dr. Marbut's proposed plan?
Sure. I think the conversation will continue between the elected officials of the 12 recommendations that Dr. Marbut's laid out, which ones will he accept and which ones will we prioritize to work on first? And so, some of that's yet to be determined. There's still more conversations that need to be had. But I think that they'll see a lot of activity around the family and children issue that is so much at a crisis level that Dr. Marbut's highlighted. Mm-hmm. And really just the fact that he's been here over the last 3 months has already sparked a lot of activity in our community around the family and children's issues, especially in South County with Gulf Coast Community Foundation and the Schoolhouse Link holding community meetings and doing some case management discussions around families, starting to see some improvements there. So I think this will be an interesting issue to watch. I think that it will be, if we can pull the system together and work unified, I think we'll have very noticeable change in our community across all levels of our homeless populations.
Dr. Marbut, with this proposal and this plan and your experience, it seems that everyone's really been positive in moving forward. But what would happen if we didn't move forward and address the homelessness?
That's about the only thing I can guarantee. I guarantee if you keep doing the same thing, mm-hmm. the same way you're doing it, you're going to get the same exact results. So if you don't change, if you like the way it's going now and you don't change, say, all right, it's going to be that way, and it's going to be a lot worse. There's more combat veterans that are homeless that are coming into the homeless community, and you also have an increase in domestic violence, normally with single moms, not always, but that's the largest group. And then you're also, your economic, even though the general economy of the country is getting better, in terms of people with less than 5 years education, their unemployment rate has actually continued been increasing during this time. And so those three factors, combat veterans, increased domestic violence, and the economy, are only going to add more to the homeless community here. And so if you do nothing, look at what you have, and then increase it by about 20 to 25% over the next 2 to 3 years. And that's what, if everybody fast forward, that's what the community will look like, is basically 1/4 more people on the streets would be most likely if you keep the statistical trends going.
Well, I can imagine our viewers don't want that, and they want to be involved. You know, in your plan, we talked about, you know, with panhandling and not, you know, being a community of enablers. What would be your advice to individuals who are making that drive to work, and they see that individual on the corner holding that sign? What can people do as individuals? You know, what would be your suggestion?
I think there, if a person gives $1 a day, which seems to be about what a lot of people I hear in Sarasota give, that's $250 a year if you just did your business days. It'd be way better to cut that check to a Salvation Army or to Harvest or Family Promise, to an agency that's doing very, very good work in the homeless community, and just cut a $250 check or 4 checks a year to one of those really well-run agencies. Because if you give $1 out a window, 93% of it goes to alcohol, and this is for a male homeless person, it goes to alcohol, drugs, and prostitution. And so if you think 93% is a good investment in alcohol and substance abuse and prostitution, keep giving that $1 out the window. Mm-hmm. But if you stop and say, I know it's well-intended and it may pull on your strings, and you read the we call it fly the flag, whatever flag they're flying, if you take that money and put it into a well-run operation, that person knows of Salvation Army, that person knows of Harvest, they know of the programs out there. And so the best thing we can do as a just average citizen is donate to well-run agencies that are not enabling but are holistically engaging, and do not feed on the street but feed inside of existing programs. And if the average community person does those two things, it makes the life a lot better for the politicians. I'm always amazed how many average citizens says, you know, the politician needs to do this, and then I ask, well, what do you do? And say, oh, well, I give $1 a day or $2 a day. Well, you're actually growing the homeless problem. And I know that's hard because it's a very well-intended and a good-natured, and I've never seen a place that has so many people want to help. But the best way to help is not enable.
Dr. Marbut, we appreciate you coming in the studio and your insight. And Wayne, you have a tall task ahead of you with the plan and the proposal and helping to facilitate the community's way ahead. And we appreciate you coming in the studio and your time today. And thank you for watching. If you'd like to learn more about Dr. Marbut's report, please visit the county's website, scgov.net. Thanks for watching.